Hello, dear friends. How are you doing? Long time no see. For this sheet, a video on my portfolio, the crypto market cap, the Trollo trend line, plotted out and looking at the crypto market cap that's been going up well, and also Bitcoin, BCH, a look at the same Trollo chart and where we are. First, my portfolio been doing very well. Average return of now 50% since 2008. Compound annual growth rate, deducting 5% per year for the real inflation. This is the US dollar returns, and that drops about 5% per year, the value of the US dollar. So I deduct that. But net, I still have 50% per year, which is a tremendous return. Very proud of for such a long duration at 2008 till today. That's many years, no? 13 years or so. How does my portfolio look these days? Crypto has gone up. It used to be like 40% exposure. But it has gone up to about 70% exposure, of which still the smallest exposure to Ethereum and the largest by far to Bitcoin Cash, almost 60% exposure. So my portfolio is now a majority exposed to Bitcoin Cash. It has gone up, Bitcoin Cash, to 830. The bottom was many years ago, around $100. It's been a long time, around 200, 300, and then it's been going up now the past few months from around 400 to about 800 now. Ethereum also on the rise, breached its all-time high, but likely going to 10K over the next few months already, and Bitcoin Cash likely going to 30K over the next few months. It's going parabolic. So I think we will be very quickly at the peak here at this rate. Let me share that also on looking at the Trollo chart here of the crypto market cap. So we are at 2.2 trillion, but we went up very quickly this year here. We started at 1 trillion at the end of the year in December, and let's go here, January. At the start of the year, we didn't breach the all-time high, but the first days of this year, in January, the third or fourth, we broke the all-time high of 800 billion. So this year we broke the all-time high at the start, 800 billion, and we went to double that immediately, 1.6 trillion in 1 month and a half. Went sideways a little here, the first month sideways a little, and continue its rise up. So if you look at these Bitcoin of crypto bubbles, they always go, they go less steep. This was very steep, a little bit less steep, a little bit less steep, and a little bit less steep, and so the inclination is less, the growth rate is less over time, but it's still of course spectacular, because we double, it's still parabolic, this growth rate, you're very low, you can see a clear parabolic trend line again, that leads to a doubling, doubling rate that is faster and faster. And for example, we went basically from 1 trillion to 2 trillion the past 3 months, January, February, and March, it took to basically go from 1 trillion to 2 trillion. So likely we will double again, but not in 3 months, but maybe in 1 month and a half to around 4 trillion. And I shared it also 5 days ago here on noise.cash, of course, guys. If you want to follow my work these days, I post most valuable content on noise.cash. We will likely like double in another, not 3 months, but another 1 month and a half or so, to from 2 to 4 trillion. And then there's only one doubling left, and that will be probably the month after. So expect for in only 3 months, we will go from 2 trillion to about 7 trillion or so. And we are today at the Trollo chart at 350% overvaluation here. Yes, we're at 2.2 trillion. The fair value, the trend line here stands at around 630 billion. So we're about 350% compared to the trend line. The trend line being 100%. And we expect to only go to 800%. And if you build in a margin of safety, you can see this going down. Every bubble, you have less overvaluation. Actually, you should, of course, lock in profits at 600% here. We're at 350, 600%. Of course, in the meantime, the trend line does go up because we're above it. And so as long as the prices are above the trend line, it gets pulled upwards a bit every time. So if I look at my crypto investment plan here, then I think my estimate is realistic. This will be the peak, probably 800% versus the trend line, already in the middle of the year, by August or so. At that point, the trend line will not be 600 billion, but 900 billion. And you take in 800% of that, you're at 7 trillion, but you probably need to like lock in profits here. That's the safe margin here, and that's already at 5 trillion, not at 7 trillion. And that's not at 30K, where I expect Bitcoin BCH to peak out, but at 15K, that you start to lock in profits strong. And that's not at 10K for Ethereum, but at 5K for Ethereum. So Ethereum only has one doubling left, and two doublings. Bitcoin BTC, Segwit coin, also known as Segwit coin, or bank, the banker coin these days, only has one doubling left because it's already at 60K. And the peak is very likely to be only 100K or so. But you cannot like try to lock in profits at the peak. That's very risky. It's much safer to leave the last doubling to the courageous ones and lock in profits before that. Why? Because it's going to go very fast. This is a matter of weeks that you do the last doubling, and after that you have lots of flash crashes, and it's much more pleasant to lock in profits on the way up than to try to chase the price down and lock in profits that way. What you can of course also always do is wait for the rebound, wait for the crash and then the rebound and sell then. That's of course a very typical pattern that you see. After every, if you zoom in, you always see like a crash from the top and then a rebound. A crash from the top and a rebound. So that's like crash from the top and a rebound. You can of course wait for that also, but it also depends on how much capital you invest, because liquidity is the lowest. Like nobody is selling on the way up, everybody is hodling. So if you're, that's why prices go parabolic, because you have less and less sellers, because every seller says like, damn, I shouldn't have sold. Look, the price is up again today. And so people start to sell less and less and less, but greed is picking up also. And people that didn't buy say, damn, I should have bought. And so what you see is that the maximum volume is not at the peak. It's once it starts crashing, there's lots of volume, because then suddenly everybody wants to buy and sell. But yeah, it's rush hour then. It's better to do it beforehand when there is actually little selling, then you're the only one basically offering something for sale and it gets eaten up quickly on the way up. I like to sell that way. So we're not that far off that moment, but we're too soon. Huh? Like if you look here, like it is too soon to sell. Why? Because the chance is very low that we're at the peak today. For many reasons that I'm not gonna go through, but for which I recommend Colin Talks Crypto is I shared on Noise 4 weeks ago. And he goes to many indicators. One of them also being the troll trend line, but many others where he goes through how likely it is that we reach the peak, and he says that it's like 70% certain. There are only a few where you could say like, yes, we're very close to the peak. NUPL is 95%, so almost hit the peak, but the other ratios not yet. For example, Trollo trend line also, we're only 60% from the peak. There's another 40% to go. And of course, like it depends a lot also what you're invested in, because there's a big difference of course between BTC and the other cryptocurrency. I think BTC actually has many flashing indicators at the peak. For example, we see celebrities investing in BTC. BTC is talked about in many places, but okay, if you look at Google search trends and some indicators like likely not at the peak yet, but we can't be that far off when celebrities are also investing in it and peacocking it on their social media, such as the beautiful lady from Hilton Hotels. Can't find it now. Still some time to go, but it's probably going to go fast. If you look at Bitcoin BCH, the trend line is pulled downwards. When I shared this sheet for the first time a month or 2 months ago, the trend line, if I extrapolated, was at today at 125 billion. But once I fill in all the numbers of the past few months, the trend line has gone up in 1 month and a half from like 10 billion the last time I reported on this to 15 billion, so plus 50% for BCH. But in the meantime, the trend line went down because BCH valuations are below the trend line. So every time you do that, you always get pulled down a little bit more the trend line. Huh? And so, for example, it should be 125 billion, but then when you recalculate the trend line with the last month's price data, actually it gets pulled down again. It's not 125, it's 110 billion. That's the fair value of Bitcoin BCH right now. But that's still almost 10 times higher than where the actual market value is, which is only 15 billion. I still have lots of catching up to do here. You also see that other ratios of the BCH versus BTC price, the BCH versus Ethereum price, they're still close to all-time lows, but not at the all-time low anymore. We used to be at a ratio of 100, but now a ratio of 80 or so for Bitcoin, for BTC versus BCH. Of course, my strategy is not to sell. If you want to do 100 baggers, you need to hold them till they 100 back and then you sell them. So I use the Kelly criterion to invest, but once I'm invested, I'm not gonna the famous lady of the ARK invest funds does trade around position, as they give it a beautiful name, which means once Tesla goes higher and 10% exposure, you're always selling and selling and selling. And of course, then it's hard to make lots of money when you're always locking in profits and constantly shipping away from your position. You have to keep your position intact the whole way up, and then you sell strong at the top. That's the challenge, huh? And that's what we will try to do also. But that means basically that you don't sell anything and only start selling when you're at reached extreme overvaluation, when different indicators show that it's likely the top. And that means using a Trollo chart, but also other things like how much do people talk about it, what's the sentiment in the community. And there I actually have made a mistake with Tesla. People that follow my work saw that I sold around 1,500 and my full position, but also held from around $200 to around $1,500. But it continued to go up. I hadn't, yes, according to the Trollo trend line, it was seriously overvalued. But I should have looked also at other indicators because the sentiment was not yet overly greedy. It's not that everybody was talking about Tesla yet, but that's the case today. After we doubled again from 1,500 to 3,000 or 4,000, of course there was a stock split, so that's now by 5, but we're now around 700, 800, so you do times 5, that's about 3,500, that's now the price of Tesla. So it doubled again after I thought we hit the peak. Very likely to happen again with BCH, especially considering this chart, where a fair valuation is so much higher, and then you're just at fair valuation. Likely, you're going to overshoot that, at least to the green line. And where is that now? Let's take a look. It's right here. It's 370 billion, and that's times 20 from here. We're at, that's almost 15K, 20K. But at that point in time, it could double again shortly, and it could go above the green line, because average to the mean and a reversion to the mean goes in both ways. The more you are getting depressed, the more likely you will overshoot also tremendously. So that's the big risk of Bitcoin BCH, that it may actually reach these kind of valuations again. Where it goes to, how much? 1,000% over the fair value. That means you go to 1 trillion. Not 100 billion, but 1 trillion. That's possible. It's not probable, but it is possible to reach in 3 months. It's crazy. But actually, many cryptos have done this in the past, such massive gains in such a short time frame. Almost all of whom that I missed personally, but maybe I'll pick up one now. And the narrative is there, like the story is there. You always need, you need of course the logistics to be in place for that to happen. Basically a huge shortage in supply and a very huge demand. And a very big gap between these that's possible for Bitcoin BCH when the narrative changes, like, oh my God, BTC is actually not Bitcoin. Look, it's indeed not peer-to-peer cash, and it's unusable. Transaction fees are now a few hundred dollars per transaction. Everybody suddenly realizes, and that's when you get a tipping point, like when 20% of the mass market or of the BTC fans realize that, oh my God, actually it's not the real Bitcoin. Or 20% of the market, and suddenly you get a tipping point, and then you can go to like, oh, but it is BCH, that's actually the real Bitcoin. And suddenly you get a very big flip in supply demand that may cause such valuations. And then you sold that, if you sold it all at the, what you think was the top, you may have very sore grapes just a month later. So that's a bit the problem also here.